Hi, welcome to the Rockport VAL office training video. My name is Lynn Clark, Head of Client Services here at VAL. In today's training video, we will walk you through how to create a new model from scratch, how to set up assumptions, enter income and expenses, set up the rent roll, including rent steps and recoveries, create rollover leasing assumptions, valuation sets, view key reports, and create a simple scenario. At the bottom of the video is the video progress bar. Here you can jump to specific topics within the video. Let's get started. To create a property from scratch, click on the orange New Property button from the main screen. Enter the property name and select office as the property type. The address is linked with Google Maps and will auto-complete as you begin to enter the location of the asset. Click the Create button to create the model. When you open up VAL, at the top of the screen is the header displaying key performing metrics. On the left side of the screen is the navigation pane where we enter data into VAL and view reports. First, open up model settings and establish the timing of the analysis, which is starting in January of 2022 over a 10-year hold. Next, let's enter growth rates. The growth rates are located in the assumption section in the navigation pane. There are 6 growth rates within VAL. However, you can add as many growth rates that are applicable to the property. Everything will grow by the general growth rate unless you specify an override. In our example, the general growth rate is 3%. Next, let's model vacancy loss. The vacancy and collection loss is an adjustment to the potential revenue of the cash flow, factoring likely vacancy loss due to market conditions. Let's add a 5% vacancy loss factor. Next, let's add miscellaneous income. The miscellaneous income is where revenue-generating items not associated to a lease is entered, such as parking and vending revenue. In our example, vending income is $2,500 a month, growing by the miscellaneous growth rate. To add additional line items, click on Add Income from the top right-hand corner of the screen. The parking deck is $10 per occupied area, growing by the miscellaneous growth rate. Click on the Unit of Measure drop-down menu and select Dollar per Area and choose Occupied Area as the area measure. This will base the revenue on the occupancy of the building. All operating expenses, whether reimbursable or non-reimbursable, are entered in the Operating Expenses screen. Here, we will leverage VAL's copy and paste functionality from Excel. Right-click on the line item and select Clone X Times to add the same number of rows that exist in the Excel model. In our example, we will add 10 rows. Click Control-C to copy the data from Excel and Control-V as in Victor to paste into VAL. This saves a great deal of time when adding or updating expense details. Let's update a few of our expense details. The management fee is 3% of EGR. Click on the Unit of Measure drop-down menu and select Percent of EGR and enter 3 as the amount. Next, let's discuss parent subaccount relationships. Electric, gas, and water are subaccounts of utilities. Click on the checkboxes next to each of those line items and select the Add to Parent button located on the top right-hand corner of the screen. Enter the name, which is utilities, and click Enter. This will set the parent-child relationship up in VAL where we can expand to view the details. Capital expenses are displayed below NOI on the cash flow. We have a building repair that is a one-time cost of $55,000 in June of 2024. Click on the amount pencil icon to display the grid that shows every month of every year of the analysis where we can enter the amount in a specific month the cost incurs. The rent roll is where we model the contractual or speculative leases. We will leverage VAL's copy and paste functionality to efficiently populate tenant data into the model. Right-click on the line item and select Clone X Times and clone 14 times to add the same number of rows that exist in Excel. Select the cells to copy in Excel and click Control-C to copy and Control-V as in Victor to paste the tenant name, suite, floor, lease start and end date, area, and base rent amount into VAL. Rent steps are increases to the base rent over the term of the lease that can be entered as either a dollar amount or a percentage increase. Let's edit rent steps for Blackstone. Blackstone and all tenants have a 3% rent step. Click on the Date Type drop-down menu and select Relative. This is useful to be able to reuse this rental step variable across all tenants who share the same rental increase structure. Enter the start date is 13, meaning the 13th month of the lease, the value is 3, and the unit of measure is percent annual increase. VAL automatically saves as you go. However, when in a pop-up screen, clicking Save is required. Once we have created the rent step structure, we can click Ctrl-C to copy and Ctrl-V to paste to all tenants who share the same rent step structure. Next, let's discuss recoveries. There are two default recovery methods in VAL, default base year and default triple net. In our example, all tenants pay triple net reimbursements, excluding Blackstone, who has a unique recovery structure. We can copy and paste the default triple net structure across all tenants. In instances where tenants have a more complex recovery structure, we create methods. Blackstone pays their pro rata share of CAM above a $3 million base stop plus a 15% administration fee and net of property taxes. First, from the navigation pane, let's set up the expense pools. Click Add Pool and enter CAM as the name. Here we can select which expenses are included in CAM and click Save. Next, we create the methodology. Click on the Methods tab and select Add Method to build the recovery method. We will name this recovery Blackstone and select the CAM expense pool from the drop-down menu. Select Base Stop as the recovery structure and enter the $3 million base stop amount. In addition, let's set up the 15% administration fee by clicking on the drop-down menu and adding the 15%. Click Add Recovery Method to add an additional column where we can model the property taxes to be reimbursed net. You can repeat this process for each expense pool with a unique structure and click Save. Now that we have created the recovery method, we need to apply it to the tenant. Open the rent roll screen and assign the recovery structure to Blackstone. In the navigation pane, we can click on Audit and view the recovery audit report to display a detailed report that tracks how VAL is calculating Blackstone's reimbursements, showing the expense pools, base stop amounts, and the details behind the recovery calculation. Going back to the rent roll, the rollover assumptions define the projected lease assumptions after the initial lease expires based on if the tenant vacates or renews their lease. The upon expiration field defines how VAL will calculate the rollover assumptions based on if you think the existing tenant will renew, vacate, exercise an option, or will go dark and be reconfigured. Market is the default setting and will weigh the new and renewal assumptions based on the renewal probability. Click on the rollover assumptions drop-down menu and select Add New to create the office rollover assumptions, where the renewal probability is 80%, the term is 5 years, where we can enter 60M for months or 5Y for years. Downtime is 6 months. And market rent is $65 for new and $60 for renew. Note the market rent entered is as of the beginning of the analysis period and will assume the growth rate if a lease starts in the future. If you want to have increases to the rent during the lease term, this is modeled in the interim adjustments, where in our example, we will model a 3% increase. Free rent for new tenants is 3 months, for renewing tenants is 0. Tenant improvements is $30 for new and $15 for renew. Leasing commissions is 6% for new and 3% for renewal. And the recovery structure is default base year, where the base stop is reset based on the first year's operating expenses. Once we have created the rollover assumptions, let's copy and paste the rollover assumptions across all tenants. Next, let's model the vacant spaces. We have already estimated when leases will begin. Typically, the base rent for vacant spaces is 100% of market rent, where the market rent is driven by the rollover assumption applied to the space. We will add 3 months of free rent. And for the recoveries, tenant improvements, and leasing commissions, we will select to use RLA, where the assumptions will be driven from the rollover leasing assumptions assigned to the tenant.
The advantage of using this option is if the market assumptions change, that change will be reflected in both the rollover leasing assumptions and the vacant spaces. A stacking plan is available to view a snapshot of the rent roll at any point in time and based on the floor and suite numbers. The stacking plan can be pushed out to a future date and can be copied and pasted into your presentation. In the valuation screen, set up an unlimited number of valuations to calculate a DCF, direct cap, or purchase price to value your asset. Let's set up a DCF valuation based on a 6% cap and an 8% discount rate over a 10-year hold. In addition, let's add a 2% cost of sale. Click on Add Valuation to set up the second valuation, which we will call Direct Cap, and select Direct Capitalization from the drop-down menu and enter a 6.5% cap rate. What's nice about entering the valuation sets is on the first column, VAL will display the results of each valuation as entered. That's it. We have completed all the inputs and now we'll review the outputs. There are over 80 reports available in VAL. We will go through a few of the key reports. The cash flow report displays the revenue and expenses. There is drill down capabilities on this report to display the tenant level data of each line item. In addition, you can quickly view results of selected cells on the status bar located at the bottom of the screen. All reports can be exported to Excel by clicking on the Excel icon on the top right-hand corner of the screen. Click on the Tenant Cash Flow tab to view the individual tenant cash flow report of any tenant by selecting from the drop-down menu. The Investment Analysis Report displays the IRR, cash-on-cash, and equity multiples. From the reporting parameters, select the value to be used as the time zero value. We will select the DCF valuation set, which has the exit cap entry included. The report will display a summary of the cash flow, the time zero value, and resale, and the unleveraged IRR, cash on cash, and equity multiples are displayed at the bottom. Click on the Return Sensitivities tab, where several matrices are available for you to analyze the optimal investment analysis. There are four valuation reports available by navigating the tabs at the top of the screen. The Sales Yield Matrix report displays the value based on a range of discount rates and a range of cap rates. You can toggle between the valuation sets from the drop-down menu. The Prospective Present Value report calculates the value in each year of the hold and includes the residual value and going-in cap rate. The Rent Roll report nicely displays the tenant information and includes rent escalations and recovery structures. The Rollover report displays the rollover assumptions included in the model, and the Individual Rollover Assumptions tab displays the growth factor applied to the assumption so you can see the terms of a future lease in the year of rollover. To view the tenant exposure, the lease expiration displays how much square footage is expiring every year, and you can click on the Initial Terms tab to view which tenants are expiring. Once you have identified which reports to include in your analysis, go to Settings and Package to create a report package where you can select the reports and click Create Package for VAL to email you an Excel workbook that includes all of your favorite reports in one consolidated package. Leveraging VAL scenarios and sets allows you to explore an unlimited number of best and worst case scenarios. Click Add Scenario and let's name this Upside Scenario. Here you can sensitize rollover assumptions, growth rates, vacancy collection loss, and the rent roll. Let's create a simple example and click on the RLA set drop-down menu and create an upside RLA scenario. Update the renewal probability to 90% and enter a $70 per square foot market rental rate. Then click back to Scenario Manager and let's view the scenario comparison report to display how the baseline compares with our upside scenario we just created. Here we can select what data attributes to display on each axis of the comparison report. In addition to the scenario comparison report, toggle between scenarios to update results on all reports in VAL. Here is the baseline results on the cash flow report, and here is the upside result, noting the valuation in the header has also updated with the upside assumptions.
This concludes the Rockport VAL training video. Additional resources are available to ensure you are successful, such as training videos and dozens of tutorial videos. or reach out to our award-winning support team at support@rockportval.com to schedule a training or receive support, all at no additional cost. Thank you.